So, in this series of lecture videos, we're going to be talking about what's called fiscal and monetary policy. And fiscal and monetary policies are things the government can do to attempt to change the level of aggregate demand. Because we might find ourselves in a situation where the economy is not recovering from a recession fast enough, or where we're experiencing an unwanted increase in inflation due to a boom or something like that. And sort of one of the things we worry about, we think that probably the economy does eventually adjust to its long-run equilibrium in the aggregate demand, aggregate supply model. But the speed of that adjustment is something that we would worry about. So just to review here, we have our long-run aggregate supply curve, and that represents the economy producing its natural rate of output, or its natural rate of GDP, and we have the aggregate price level, something like the GDP deflator on that axis. And we think that recessions in this model are caused, say for instance, by a fall in aggregate demand. And that causes us to move from a point like A to a point like B. And then gradually, various sort of internal processes in the economy to do with wage and price adjustment or how people change their expectations moves us to something like this, short-run aggregate supply, two, and GDP recovers its formal level. But how fast is this is an open question. One thing to notice here is that kind of how easily this can happen depends upon the shape of the aggregate demand curve. So, if we think that the aggregate demand curve is pretty flat, so that it's kind of shaped like this, and here's our aggregate supply curve, and then we have a leftward shift, and this is sort of a big leftward shift here of the aggregate demand curve. I'm going sort of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 boxes left. If we have a big leftward shift of the aggregate demand curve, if the aggregate demand curve is pretty flat, then the amount of price adjustment that we need to get back, excuse me, this is number one, this is number two, the amount of price adjustment we need to get back to our former level of GDP is relatively minor. So flat aggregate demand curve means quick recovery from a recession. On the other hand, if I had drawn this with a steep aggregate demand curve, and I'm not even going to be able to shift it a whole 10 boxes left, but let's suppose I even shift it sort of 5 boxes left, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then we're going to go ahead and see that, one, the recession is going to be much more drastic. Two, it's going to require a heck of a lot of price adjustment to get all the way back down to our normal level of GDP. So a steep aggregate demand curve makes the economy self-correction mechanism slow and difficult. And it might be that the aggregate demand curve slope isn't constant over time. So remember that the three reasons we have for why aggregate demand slopes down are a wealth effect. The interest rate effect. And the nominal, sorry, the real exchange rate effect. So normally, when there's a decrease in the price level, the real value of people's nominal money holdings goes up. So that when there's a decline in the price level, people are wealthier and therefore they spend more. But this sort of assumes that people have positive net assets. If people have a very high level of debt, then it's also going to be true that although the real value of their money goes up, the real value of their debts also goes up. So that this effect would become weaker when we have high levels of debt. The interest rate effect, we'll see in a second here, this is what we call the theory of liquidity preference. The idea here is that a lower price level decreases the demand for money because you don't need as much money to get through all of your transactions, and therefore a lower demand for money produces lower interest rates. Okay. This is going to be limited in effect when interest rates are near zero. And the real exchange rate effect is basically the idea that as the price level goes down, say in the United States, U.S. exports look more competitive overseas. So if you were to look at the situation of the U.S. economy in the wake of the 2007-2008 financial crisis and recession, you know, we do have high levels of debts. And interest rates were already pretty low before the recession started and have already pretty much gone down to zero. It's not clear how much further decreases in the price level are going to be able to cause interest rates to go down because they're already pretty close to zero. So pretty much we're only left with one reason why the aggregate demand curve slopes down. So it's pretty plausible that in the aftermath of that recession, our aggregate demand curve is pretty steep. And correspondingly, this may be one reason why the sort of self-correction or the ability of the economy to recover from the recession has been pretty weak. And I'll go ahead and leave it there, and then in the next segment, I'll go ahead and start talking about monetary policy.